name is Ayshi, and today I'm just going to read out a short story on Tenali Raman. But you might not know who actually is Tenali Raman, but that's okay. I'll read a short note about him. Tenali Raman, who lived in the early 16th century, is regarded as one of the most popular folk figures in India today, also dubbed the Birbal of the South. Raman was the royal jester at the court of Krishna Devarai of Vijayanagar in Andhra Pradesh. It was under Krishna Devarai's rule that Vijayanagara Empire, one of the most famous empires in the history of southern India, is considered to have reached its peak. The king himself was a mighty warrior who rarely lost a battle but treated his enemies with honor. Tenali Raman was one of the 8 poets of great stature of his court. Not only was he a great Telugu poet, but also he was a notable for his knowledge, wit, and ingenuity. Okay, now you know a little about Tenali Raman. After reading this story, you will get to know more about him. The name of the story is 2 Boons. However enraged Raman's victim were, after one look at his bright eyes and plump cheeks, they would invariably forget their wrath and say, "Oh, run away, you naughty boy, and don't you dare play a prank on me again." Raman would run off to find his next victim, or stretch out under his favorite palmyra tree for a satisfying snooze. At the end of each day, he trudged home to his mother, who wrung her hands and her son's misdeed and wonder what he would make of his life. There was no doubt that Raman was smart. From the time that his uncle had brought his widowed sister and her son back to his village, Tenali, little Ramalinga, or Raman as he was usually called, had delighted his elders with his intelligence. But he had a intensely irritated love for mischief. Every day posed a new trial for his teacher, who found that no amount of cajoling, threatening, or beating would quell the high-spirited boy.
"Not only, he is possibly mischief," complained the teacher to Raman's uncle, "but he is also unbearable lazy. He can put his mind to anything if he wants to, but he chooses not to."
"What will become of him?"
queried the anxious uncle, who strove to hide his fondness for his nephew under a gruff exterior.
"Is there no hope?"
"Not at all," said the teacher grimly. "He will be the world's largest and greatest prankster and idler. On the other hand," he added quickly, seeing the uncle's face fall, "you can pray for a miracle. Perhaps he will be a great man someday."
Raman's uncle died when Raman was still very young, and the boy and his mother lived in the extreme poverty and hardship. Yet Raman showed no sign of reforming his way, and his tomfoolery reached new heights. That year, there was a drought. The citizens of Tenali searched the sky with anxious eyes for signs of rain as the land grew more and more parched. Finally, when all hope seemed lost, a venerable old man, a sannyasi, entered the village. Soon after, there was rain. The people of Tenali danced with wildly and cries of joy and relief. The sannyasi was proclaimed a savior or a miracle man. Everyone was awed by the magic he had wrought. Well, everyone was, except Raman. The boy went up to the sannyasi and said, "How's the old palmyra tree?" The sannyasi nodded appreciatively, but
Everyone else looked completely mystified. As Raman turned and was walking away, a friend accosted him.
What did you mean by that?
It's simple, answered Raman. A crow sat on a branch of palmyra tree and a fruit fell down. Everyone immediately thought that the bird had done it. It's the same with the sannyasi. He entered the village and it rained. So everyone thinks he's a miracle man or a magician. People, what are they?
Quite right, said an amused voice behind him. It was the sannyasi.
His friends turned tail and ran back to Raman, stood his ground.
My boy, the sannyasi went on. I really appreciate your bright face and quiet wit. What do you do for a living?
Raman could hardly say that he spent a large part of his day sleeping. So he lied with a straight face and he could muster. I don't have very good health, he began.
Oh, that is terrible.
The sannyasi sounded deeply concerned.
Well, I'm going to help a deserving boy like you. I will teach you a mantra to invoke Goddess Kali. Sit in her temple tonight and recite it. When she comes before you, ask boldly for what you want.
Raman was instantly curious. Was the sannyasi really serious about this?
That night, Raman made his way to the small Kali temple near his house. There was not a soul in sight, but even so, he closed the door after he went in so as to remain unobserved. Then he began starting to chant the mantra. It felt like a little scary at first, chanting loudly in the dark with no one in here or see him but an unmovable idol. Nevertheless, he kept at it and was rewarded in a most spectacular fashion. Just as he had chanted Kali's name 100,000 times, there appeared a frightening figure before him.
It was Goddess Kali with thousands of head. His eyes were huge and fiery and blood dripping off her tongues.
Raman stared at apparition with wide eyes. Kali stared back at him furiously. Then, most unexpectedly, Raman burst out laughing. His guffaws filled the room and tears of merriment rolled from his cheeks. The goddess's expression changed. People swooned, cried, and trembled at her appearance, but no one had ever laughed.
Why do you laugh? She demanded, her voice and deep and ear-inspiring.
Forgive me, goddess,
gasped Raman, wiping away his tears and trying to speak steadily.
But I suddenly wondered what you would do if you caught a cold. I have such a problem with just one nose dripping, but you have a thousand.
Kali's eyes glowed with red and anger. Then all at once, she too began to laugh, and she kept it up for so long that Raman began to get a little worried. At length, she stopped and looked at Raman with affection.
You Vikatakavi, she said. You have no idea how long it is since someone dared to joke with me. I feel good to laugh.
I like the title, Clever Buffoon, said Raman, relieved. It reads the same from either end. I couldn't have asked for anything better.
Vikatakavi, and from the end is also Vikatakavi.
Wow!
Kali impensely held out two golden bowls, one in each hand. Look, Raman, she said. The bowl in my right hand has the sweet milk of learning, while the one in my left hand has the sour curd of wealth. Choose one, and you shall have it. Raman considered a while. This was a difficult choice. Knowledge or wealth? Should he choose the left? Nah. The right? Aloud, he said, Mother, why is it wealth associated with sour curd? Because wealth is hardly even acquired by pleasant means, retorted Kali. Raman made up his mind. How can I choose? O Kali, without tasting them both, he said. All right, taste a bit of both, offered the goddess. Before she quite knew what was happening, Raman had gulped down the content of both bowls. The goddess's eyes began to glow with rage. Forgive me, I had to have both. Without one, nobody will use the other. That's why I gulped both in, said Raman.
You imp! Exclaimed Kali, torn between anger and laughter. You disobeyed me and will have to pay for this. So while you will be a great poet, you will be better known as a jester, for that it what comes naturally to you. And your prosperity will bring you several enemies, but with my blessing, you will outwit each of them. Then, with a parting smile, as she remembered Raman's first comments, Kali disappeared into the thin air. Raman was completely thrilled beyond measure. He mumbled his thanks to the space where she had been and left the temple to lie down under his favorite Pamira tree. As Raman lay in the darkness, he could hardly believe his luck. All at once, Tenali seemed too small a place for a man of his learning and ability. But where could he go? He thought and thought. Suddenly, a solution struck him quite suddenly. He would go to Vijayanagar, to the court of Krishna Devarai. The king was famous for promoting poets and writers, and for surrounding himself with the people of intelligence and merit. He was apparently a very generous patron, but there was a flip side too, one of which he was equally famous. The king's temper was said to be frightening. In a bad mood, he could fling around the death sentences like breeze, scattering pollen in the air. Lying under his tree, Raman smiled confidently to himself. He had his boons and he could succeed. The end. So this was the, this is a very cool story. I really like the story. So on the next time, I will read another story on Tenali Raman. Bye for now. See you.
And don't forget to bang on the subscribe button, hit the like button, and of course, turn on the notification for all recordings that I'm gonna send. And of course, toodles!